Welcome to the PROCAS Expense User Training Series. In this video, we will go over how to create a new expense report and the information that is displayed. When you log in, if you are a timesheet user, you will see your current timesheet. Let's click Expenses on the main menu bar so that we can create a new expense report. The Expenses menu gives you a list of all the things you can do as an expense report user. To create a new expense report, click Go here. We recommend that you create an expense report as soon as possible and add expenses as you go. You don't have to finish your expense report in one sitting, since the system will save your expenses as you record them. When you create a new expense report, the system requires that you give it a name before you can start adding any expenses. The federal government requires that you receive proper authorization for direct travel in advance of your trip. While the expense report purpose or remarks aren't required by the system, you can use this space to record the authorization. Basically, the who, the what, and the why of your trip should be recorded here. If you've received an advance for your expenses, record that amount here. When you're finished, click Save and Edit Expense Report. This creates a new, blank expense report. The system will automatically give each new expense report a unique number, which is displayed at the top. This number is used internally as a reference for accounting and documentation purposes. Let's see what the expense report would look like with some detail information. Here's the expense report after some lodging expense has been recorded. A completed expense report will have three sections: the header, which will display information for the expense report as a whole, the details, which have the specific information for each expense, ending with a total for the expense report, and the footer, which is where the various expense report functions will be available. In the expense report header, you'll see your name and employee number, the expense report name, and the purpose information that you've entered. You can click on the links to go back and edit the header information at any time. On the right, you'll see a link to view per diem allowances and a link to add meals and incidental expenses at per diem rates. In the details section, what you see will depend on the types of expenses that you have recorded. You may see an overages section, which will show you any expenses that have exceeded the per diem allowance, and an itinerary section, which will show you the when and where of your trip. You'll see the expenses section, which will show you the how and how much of your trip. You'll also see the expense report totals, which include a subtotal of the receipts and expenses recorded, less any advances, business expenses paid by the company, or personal expenses paid by the company, to give you a total due to you, or, in this case, the total you owe the company. In the footer section, you'll see links on the left that allow you to open a printer-friendly version or open a PDF version. On the right is a link that allows you to establish expense allocations between multiple charge codes. To the right are buttons that correspond to various features available to you. The Print Receipts button allows you to export a PDF of all of the electronic receipts attached to your expense report. If we refer back to the diagram from the introduction video, you'll see that there are buttons that correspond to the different types of expenses. For per diem expenses, you'll first need to record where you went, when you were there, and how long you stayed. You would record this information using the Add Edit Itinerary button. Once your itinerary is entered, there are two types of per diem expenses you can record: meals and incidentals, and lodging. For meals and incidentals expenses, you must first indicate what meals were furnished, if any, using the Add Edit Furnished Meals button. Then use the Add M&IE per diem link to record the when and for what of the expense. Clicking Add Expense allows you to record the when, how much, and for what of your lodging expenses. The Add Edit Mileage button allows you to record any miles you may have traveled in your personal vehicle. For all other expenses, you would use the Add Expense button. When you finish adding all your expenses, the Submit for Approval button alerts your supervisor that your expense report is ready for their approval. Finally, you'll see the expense report status at the bottom of the screen. We've covered creating a new expense report in PROCAS Expense and what you'll see. For step-by-step instructions for using all of the features, you can download the PROCAS Expense user instructions from the Help link by clicking Downloads. Click on a link to start another training video, or see our other PROCAS Time and Expense training videos, which cover the basics for using the system.